Alright, round one with this blue-black-ish control deck. Yeah, it's a little slow, but I'll keep it. So I realized we barely saw any artifact mana, which is something I'm looking for when I get upheaval. I'm pretty sure we didn't see almost any. We did pick up that Mind Stone that I almost didn't see. I'm pretty sure there's nothing else. Alright, we got the mono white aggro player. Luckily, we were on the play this game because his hand would have been very bad on the draw. Oh! How lucky. I suppose I could have. That's really playing it too conservative. If I wanted to bounce land and then play Trinket Mage to trade, this is too conservative. Let's see. He's going to be unhappy if I play bounce land here. Now that I drew this, I have to get Chromox with Trinket Mage. I think I'm gonna be the do the bounce land play. Too much value in not letting him land hex. Something important in this matchup to be aware of is Armageddon. If we can play around it, we should. Ooh, he's playing red. Land no spell, interesting. What? Okay, that is baffling. Do we attack into that? Well, let's figure out our plan exactly. We Death Cloud is really good right now. If we play just land Death Cloud for two, discard Mox, probably upheaval, I suppose. We get to draw two cards. He'd be on two lands, two cards in hand. We'd be on three mana, four cards in hand, including a smokestack and a land or an upheaval if I want it to be. Or we could just play smokestack. Chromox, no imprint. No, that's not really gonna work because that's gonna enable his land tax. We definitely don't need a Death Cloud right away. So I think we're just gonna attack, play land and pass. Oh wow, he blocked. I didn't not expect that in a million years. Interesting. If we didn't draw these, we could have played smokestack and just passed and not never had to put a counter on it. I think we do that. And we just then we Death Cloud like reasonably soon. Yeah, we're just like we have amazing board position and we have a Death Cloud in our hand. And we have an upheaval. In two turns we could upheaval, play land, play a Chromox. It only matters if we have some kind of threat or something to follow it up with, so we're probably not gonna do that. Okay. Okay, so we didn't play land. So his land tax would trigger if we played a land. Death Cloud does not look like a very good option anymore. Activating this also doesn't look like a very good option. Okay, so we're just gonna. So we did stack it correctly. I'm not gonna put a counter, so it doesn't matter, but I wanna make sure I know how to stack it. So unfortunately, though, this means we have to just pass without doing anything. Can't even play a land. We could cycle this. But I better not. Okay. Okay, you played a land. Good. want to get cryptic active. Oh, interesting. He was about to to play something that costs more. Three cards in hand. We get Deathclad for three now. And he would have two lands and some permanents. If we put a counter on this and then do that. I think that's good. We're going to cycle this. Yeah, we're going to cycle it, because we're probably going to end up discarding it to the Deathclad. So might as well cycle it. Or we could also... No, we can't Shader's Edict yet. Oh, I put it in the wrong order this time. For if I was going to put a counter. I probably was going to put a counter, too. No, I'm not going to. So Deathclad for three. Or I could still do nothing. Really wish I put that counter on the smokestack. I would probably just pass and do nothing, and then next turn Deathclad. But yeah, I'm pretty sure we're doing nothing. We're in so much control of this game. Cloudgut Ranger. So, that would make Deathclouding not particularly good, unless we smothered first. So let's see, yeah, five creatures, smother one, Deathclad for four. Then we'd also not be able to play a land, unless we want this to trigger. So we're gonna put a counter on this. He's gonna have these three permanents roughly. Sacrifice probably the honor, or sacrifice the skull clamp. Pass out playing a land. He sacrifices the land. Then we sacrifice the smokestack. All of that doesn't do anything for me because I'm not gonna have a threat. So how do I play this where I actually can get a threat into play? It's kind of difficult. All right, I got it. We can bounce this land tax, and then he's gonna have to discard it. So we can bounce draw. Or that's pretty much the same as counter bouncing. We can just discard the smother, so that seems a little better. Or no, it's worse if he has a white source. A lot worse if he has a white source. So I guess we let that happen then. We're going to sacrifice four lands. Okay, do this correctly. The right one is first. So we're going to have one card left over with three mana. So Skin Render or Strix. I guess Strix. Definitely Strix. Could have played this very conservatively, just countered this, and then Chainer's Edicted him. But this seems to be, like, really commanding. That's funny. I'm kind of surprised. That's the permanent he chose to sacrifice. We'll sacrifice the smokestack. Oh, how lucky. Yeah, the fact that he's playing this etched oracle is so weird. Let's go ahead and draw. Yeah, we can't cast both, so we will draw. Maybe we can draw an island. Tree folk. So 3, 4, 5, 6. So we'll go Bellerin Mystic equip. Oh geez. Could be a comeback. We also can't forget we have only 12 cards in our library. Let's take a look at what they are. I know one's a Sorin, one's a Bloodline Keeper, our primary win conditions at this point. Confidant, 5 lands, a Mind Stone. So, 3 threats, a lot of do nothings, 1 hard counter, 2. I think we're definitely going to equip here, but after this, we're not going to be doing a lot of drawing cards. Yeah, I just let Jace die, I think. I'm not really going to use him anyway. Although... Nah, I have to block. If I let Jace die and I don't block, then I just have nothing to draw cards with. So I'll just draw the 2, keep the Jace around. Huh. Well... We play Lure, Animate, Equip, Attack, Pass. We could Sinkhole to be pretty safe. That's probably worth it. Jace. That's actually very stupid. I probably should have thought that turned through. Drawing a card there is definitely worth it at the beginning of the turn. It's only correct, I think, if I attack for 4, which is what I was gonna do. Okay, well now it is not gonna matter. But this is the reason why I would have been correct to draw at the beginning of the turn. Yeah, but now the game's over. He has no outs. Let's go ahead and make an emblem. see if we can end this a turn faster. Actually, I guess we'd have to take this. If he blocked, he would have been at 7. We'd only be able to attack for 6 next turn. Whoops, I was supposed to take it in response to that, too. It's still irrelevant. Yep. So disenchant could hit land tax, honor the pure, etched oracle, 4-mana 2/2. We could bring in ratchet bomb. Probably it would be better than disenchant actually to bring that in. He's not even really aggressive. He has like Baneslayer, Cloudguard Ranger. Braids is bad against a land tax deck. So just Ratchet Bomb. I'm gonna cut, I think Smother. Seems a little weird to cut Smother, but I think it's fine.